how we got here and what this case
proceedings
is
have begun in Ukraine's case against Russia at the International Court of Justice. The Ukrainian government is accusing the Kremlin of violating two UN conventions for the suppression of the financing of terrorism and on the elimination of all forms of racial discrimination. The first part of Ukraine's case alleges that Moscow is, quote, financing acts of terrorism in Ukraine by funding illegally armed groups in the occupied Donetsk and Luhansk regions, as well as in Kharkiv. Ukraine is seeking a court order forcing Russia to stop the flow of money and weapons to armed groups in occupied Ukrainian territories. Additionally, Kyiv is seeking reparations for Russian-sponsored, quote, acts of terrorism. International law professor Harold Koh, representing Ukraine, noted the stark contrast between Russia's eagerness to sign the convention on suppressing the financing of terrorism and their actions in Ukraine.
But Russia's actions since tell a different, louder story. That those who would carry out terrorist violence against Ukraine civilians have a great friend in Russia. That the Russian Federation not only fails to prevent private individuals from supporting terrorism in Ukraine, but lets its major Russian banks serve as conduits for money to be sent to groups engaged in terrorism in Ukraine. That Russia not only flagrantly violates its obligation to prevent the financing of terrorism, but itself engages in the financing of terrorism.
In the second part of the suit, Kyiv is accusing Moscow of systematically mistreating Crimean Tatars and ethnic Ukrainians in Crimea. Ukraine cites the suppression of non-Russian ethnic minorities and a, quote, campaign of disappearances and murders of Crimean Tatars in the Black Sea Peninsula. The Ukrainian government is asking for the court to compel Russia to, quote, cease and desist from the policy of cultural erasure and restore all banned media and political bodies. Professor Koh stressed Russia's blatant disregard for the human rights of Ukrainians.
The common thread is Russian contempt for the human rights of Ukrainians. Occupation authorities in Crimea have installed a regime of ethnic Russian dominance that targets for discrimination non-Russian groups, particularly the Crimean Tatar and ethnic Ukrainian populations. Their acts are not isolated, but form a consistent pattern and practice. Together, they amount to a campaign of cultural erasure, a concerted effort to deny non-Russian groups their cultural identities.
Though it's not entirely the same, some are drawing parallels to the lawsuit Georgia brought before the court for Russia's military actions in South Ossetia in 2008. Georgia lost that case. The sides will have 4 days of divided hearings to present their case at The Hague.